L'image est belle car elle est
rare. The image is beautiful because it is rare. Three ministers received at the Ministry of Overseas almost all Antillean parliamentarians just before the Council of Ministers. The meeting lasts a little over an hour. At the exit, no declaration of the government.
Everything went well with strong government commitments, you'll see.
Appointment is therefore made, especially to return on the increase of the famous MRL, the maximum limitation of residues of chloricone in food, a limitation increased in secrecy in 2013.
I think that the minister felt that we were tired of dealing with the subject of a microscope and that we really had to take the problem in a more comprehensive way, because we are dealing with a population that's really very anxious. This debate was very tense and very direct, so the principle of a moratorium of the MRL was adopted.
While all elected officials welcome the government's approach, some are skeptical about the proposals that could be made with the lack of European and national funding for the continuation of the chloricone plan 3.
Does it mean that it's still with money from Guadeloupe and Martinique that we will finance the chloricone 3 plan when we are the main victims? It's absolutely important that the government treats this problem as seriously as possible.
Since 2014, 30 million euros have already been invested in this third plan, but it is difficult for the current government to say very clearly what they have served.
My concern, above all, is to make everything we know public. We need full transparency. I think that will reassure. And that is why I'm asking for a report from independent experts for the scientific research links chloricone and disease.
The government has not committed to additional resources granted to the current plan, just wants it to make it more efficient and more transparent.